Hi, I'm Dr. Leela Mohan. I'm MD physician. I mainly practice at Manipal, Motherhood and Rainbow Hospitals. I have my own center called as Padithem Healthcare, that is in HSR, Bangalore. Swollen lymph nodes are nothing but, we'll call it as cervical lymphadenopathy. The swollen lymph nodes in the neck, the lymph nodes, what are basically these lymph nodes? Lymph nodes are small bean-shaped structures which are present in your body, which usually fights with the infection. During this fighting of the infection, the lymph nodes will get enlarged in size. So that is what we see when we touch it. There are small nodes which are present over the neck in certain infections. So now we will go in detail what infections causes this lymph node enlargement. Viral infections will cause increase in the size of the lymph nodes. That is a main particular disease. And the other one is tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is nothing but TB. So that also will easily increase the size of the lymph nodes, which definitely be a sign of infection. And there are many lymph nodes. In certain diseases, only a single lymph node or only the double lymph nodes will be enlarged. But there are in certain diseases, many lymph nodes are enlarged, which we have to be very carefully examine the lymph nodes. And you have to go to your doctor and then it has to be get it examined rather than by you. And then the third one is HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. HIV infection also causes definitely increase in the lymph node enlargement because of the infection. The immunosystemic disorders like rheumatoid arthritis, Sjogrens syndrome, lymphomas, leukemias, or any other diseases which can also cause an increase in the size of the lymph nodes. The other causes, like some of the medications also can cause increase in the size of the lymph nodes. And there's other disease called as sarcoidosis. This also will cause increase in size of lymph nodes. Sometimes the lymph nodes can stay enlarged due to infection. And then if once the infection will get resolved also, the lymph nodes can stay like that only. This particular situation we'll call it as reactive lymphadenopathy. There are certain causes, benign causes and cancerous causes, which the lymph node can be enlarged. Benign causes, usually once the infection will get resolved, the size of the lymph node will get decreased, and then the lymph nodes can get completely disappeared also. Sometimes it can be just persisting like that. And then the benign causes of the lymph nodes, usually the lymph node will not be tender, it won't be painful, it will be a little soft and easily movable. Chronic and persistent enlargement of the lymph node also is one of the reason for long-term infections where it won't be resolved completely, and certain cancerous situations also causes the enlargement of the lymph nodes. So is this lymph nodes are cancerous? So hard and fixed lymph nodes which are not movable so easily, and sometimes there will be tender or they may not be tender. Tender means like when we touch the lymph node, it will cause pain or it won't cause pain. These all things should be a concern of seriousness. You should not just leave it like that. Certain times the systemic symptoms when the enlarged lymph nodes are accompanied with the night sweats, or if the long-term fever episodes where the fever is not coming down, and then loss of weight, then the present weight, you have to keep checking even your weight also. If the size of the lymph node is not getting decreased, all these to be considered as a serious concern, and it has to be addressed by your doctor very clearly. Definitely treatment is available for the swollen lymph nodes. The main and foremost, we give the anti-inflammatory or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, which will help in reducing the tenderness of the lymph nodes. And the main part is we have to find out why the lymph nodes are enlarged. Is it a viral infection, or it's a rheumatoid infection, or like example I told, sarcoidosis or tuberculosis, anything, or is it cancerous or leukemias, lymphomas, whatever it is. We have to find out why these lymph nodes are enlarged first. Once the cause is detected, then it has to be treated appropriately. If example, we give anti-retroviral therapy, if it is a viral infection. If it is tuberculosis, RTPC treatment is there in the government, that is anti-tuberculosis treatment. There are certain drugs like Rifampicin, Isoniazid, many drugs are there which will help you in treating the lymph nodes. Or if it is a immunological disorders, we have to give immunomodulators where the infection will come down and the size of the lymph nodes also will come down. So the main thing is here we have to find out the cause of the enlargement of the lymph node, and then we have to treat the cause so that the lymph node enlargement will be reduced and then your pain will be subsided.